At first, just in March, everyone was petrified in our town, in our hospitals, in our areas.
At some point, we had something like 20 or 30% of the hospital was COVID. You know, what do you do when our 14-bed ICU overflows?
Arizona was the worst in the world, but there was this offer we were told about, and so we seized that moment.
Monoclonal antibodies were something we could begin to offer to patients, but of course, we had to develop a plan for how to do that.
It needed to work. It needed to be smooth. It needed to be easy. How do we think about it from the patient's point of view? What kind of logistical issues are they going to have, and how do we alleviate those?
We felt like our role was to offer patients an alternative to the emergency room in the hospital.
I had a particular patient of mine that sticks out in part because I treat her, I treat her husband, and I treat their young child. She's 35, but she's a pretty brittle insulin-dependent diabetic. She said, the whole process start to finish was really smooth. She was grateful for the care that had been taken. And by 3 days, she was feeling really a whole heck of a lot better and reported that within 24 hours of infusion, she felt a big difference.
One patient I remember distinctly when it comes to monoclonal antibodies was actually the husband of a nurse here. This better work. I mean, this is kind of the ultimate test, right? We put together the monoclonal antibody. And they infused this husband, you know, the spouse at our infusion center at night. A few days later, maybe a week later, I just happened to run into this nurse in the hallways, and she was just so incredibly grateful that we did all that.
It works. That we saw a cohort of people not die. And people were dying a lot in Pima County.
A 75-year-old grandmother in her 7-day follow-up call told us, "I feel great. I'm back to homeschooling my granddaughter. Thank you so much for giving me my life back." I just, what could be more fulfilling as a healthcare provider than that?